Thank you so much for joining us live in Dallas, Texas on the Valder Beebe Show as we live large and think big in Dallas, Texas all the time. I'm going to talk to Carlos Dominguez, Cisco's Carlos Dominguez, and he's going to ask us or tell us, are you addicted or connected to your smartphone? Good question. Carlos, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Valder. Great to be here. Thank you for having me.
Is that a good question? Are you addicted or connected to your smartphone? Is that a good question?
I think any question you ask is good because I'm going to have to ponder and figure out how I'm going to answer it. But, you know, the thing that this is the third year we've done this Cisco Connected World Report. And really the purpose here is to really understand the tendencies and the behaviors of the Gen Yers, the 18 to 30-year-olds. And since it's the third, we've been accumulating some of these, you know, tendencies. And, you know, the more we get, the smarter we can become and give them feedback. What really came out of this report are three major things. One is that the smartphone has moved from being a tool just like a screwdriver or maybe a coffee pot to actually being an integrated part of our lives that's with us all the time. It's almost an extension of our body. And, you know, it came across in some of the things they said. 90% of these Gen Yers said that the smartphone is an integral part of their morning routine, just like drinking coffee and brushing their teeth. They're checking, you know, their text, their social, they're, you know, posting and doing all sorts of stuff. You know, and the other thing, too, is that I know I have seen, and you probably have seen, too, Valder, as you're out there in restaurants and stuff, is 46% of the surveyed folks said that they use their smartphones during meals with friends and family. And, you know, I can attest to that, and I see it, and everything is going. So that part of that integrated into your life is something that is really major and kind of new. The second thing that came out is because it's so integrated, the line between work and home is blurred, right? Work used to be a place I used to go to. Now it's what I do for a living. And because the smartphone is now the single device that I use both for work and personal, you know, how much time I spend at work, when I do it, you know, how much personal time I do when I'm at work, you know, kind of changes, you know, on and on and on. So it's having that understanding is really good. And then the third one, which is really more from my generation, I'm definitely of the 50 plus, what came out of this thing for me was that when I read the stats, like 3 out of 4 use the phone in bed and, you know, the time to screen is very, very short. When they wake up in the morning, how long does it take them before they touch the phone? You know, 1/3 of them use it in the bathroom or 3 out of 4 use it in bed. All those facts. I remember looking at that and going, my gosh, I resemble those remarks, right? So the point being is, a year ago, there was a vast difference between usage from the Generation Y and the baby boomers. And what we're discovering now is that we're not really that different anymore because we're both seeing an equal amount of value.
No, I agree with you. You know, we all have those behaviors. And I just took time, I think this week, I don't know where I was, and I just looked at people. You know, we don't look at our world. We really don't. We just go through it. And I looked at people, and it looked like this movie that Tom Cruise did. I can't think
Minority,
of the one.
Minority Report.
Minority Report. Yeah. Everybody was looking down. They were walking on the street, but they were looking at their cell phone.
Yeah.
In
yeah.
some kind of way. And they were older. They were younger. Very, very young also, too. And I thought that was incredible.
Well, they're constantly connected, and that's really the whole thing, and we perceive value. And I mean, one of the things that I discovered, which was really interesting, is I went shopping for the holidays. And, you know, if you recall, when I was growing up, you know, the only way you could shop is you had to go to the store. Then the internet was born, and then we all went to online shopping. Let's avoid the lines. So now there's a hybrid. What people are doing is they're actually physically going to the store, but they're taking out their smartphone, running applications on it, doing comparison pricing from this store versus what's out on the web, and then also reading reviews from their peers to whether they should buy the product or whether it's any good. So
you are so on the mark, Carlos. You are. I kid you not. Went to my daughter. He does not buy a thing without scanning that little code. I don't know what it
QR
is.
QR code.
QR code.
Yeah.
She will scan it. She'll look at it, get all the prices, and said, I can get it better online. It's amazing.
It's amazing. And the good news is the retailers have caught on to that happening. So what they're trying to do now is engage you while you're in the store. Right. So if you allow them to know that you're there and they can track you while you're there, they'll send coupons to you. They'll do all sorts of things. So you got to evaluate. You know, we're going to be pushed more and more on this privacy and how much you trust people. But, you know, that's a place that it's actually clearly happening. And I think there are some benefits for those that are not that fearful of what could potentially happen there.
Carlos, I know you've been with Cisco for probably over close to 20 years now. Could you just tell us from starting to where you are, the incredibleness of the change you've seen? Because you're behind the scene in technology.
Well, Valder, it's one of the most amazing things. And you know, for your listening audience, and you know, what I would say to you is, you know, think about this. In the last 20 years, maybe a little bit over, we've had the birth of the internet. For us, we've had the birth of mobile technology. You still remember, you used to carry quarters to be able to make phone calls in a payphone, right? You know, and third, over the last 10 years, this availability of social media and Facebook and Twitter and all of these things, and the adoption rate and the shifts in behavior that these three technologies has impacted our lives is almost endless. I live on the East Coast, and we were affected by Hurricane Sandy. Nothing bad other than power. And I remember my 19-year-old turning over to me and saying, "Dad, what are we going to do? My social life is dead because we lost power."
No, how are we going to survive?
How are we going to survive? You know, I'm not connected. And the interesting thing too is there were generators running, and no one was asking for food. What they were saying is, "Can I charge my phone?"
I know there was like a convergence in some places. People were like charging up their little cell phones. They weren't trying to get food. It was amazing.
It's my link. It's my link to the world. Don't let me lose it.
Speaking of link, I got to ask you one business question because we got this on Twitter.
Yes.
How can we use the technology of the cell phone to help those of us who are entrepreneurs? This comes from Linda in Kansas.
Well, it's a great thing. I think Twitter is one of the greatest technologies to engage your audience. I mean, it's all about connecting people. And you know, and the way I view Twitter is you can become an information curator, just like a curator in a museum has their knowledge on a particular topic, and they're trying to make that experience worthwhile for you when you're visiting it. Regardless of your expertise, whether you're a chef or, you know, you make clothing or whatever it is that you do, how do you engage people and teach them what you know and curate data for them and build a relationship with them? And Twitter is an incredible source for that. And the other thing with Twitter, it's an incredible news source. I think most of the news in the future will be coming from the people in the field, which is what we're seeing everywhere, that are reporting what they're seeing. So, you know, if you're not on it, get on it. You can follow me. I'm Carlos Dominguez if you want to, and I post a lot on technology.
Carlos, you are just absolutely the coolest, the smartest that, you know, I've talked to in a long time. I want to thank you for coming on Valder BB and sharing your Cisco knowledge and your behind-the-scenes experience.
Well, I hope you have me back, Valder, and I promise we'll talk more tech.
Thank you so much. Please come back.
Take care. Thank you.